Hello everyone, this is a continuation of Vampire. Please enjoy. Hopefully this time my recording doesn't get messed up.
My blade shall pierce the pillar of Touché, to me, my servants, avenge!
cannot enter.
Sorry, this game takes so long to load.
It's locked, all right.
You killed my father. Prepare to die. I smell your fear. Touché, sir. On guard. Your hand is shaking. Touché, sir. I summon thee, my children of the night. Fight! Behold, Kinslayer, the disgrace of Sheep is once renowned. Will she be the queen again once they all share her fate?
I don't want to die.
And I did not come to kill you, Miss Fletcher.
Will you spare me then? Save this cadaverous carcass of mine. Does your heart beat a little faster now? You fancy me then, Doctor?
No, Miss Fletcher. My dead heart will beat for only one.
Ah! Is she pretty? Is she sweet and tender?
To me, yes.
Ah! I hate her already.
I know. And this is partly why you must be destroyed.
But you just said...
that I did not come here to kill you, yes. But I realize now the threat you embody must be stopped.
Will I be remembered? Will you?
You were Doris Fletcher, the greatest actress of her generation. No one can take that from you.
Thank you. And farewell. Ah! Ah! Ah!
Farewell, Doris.
Bravo! So dramatic. I love it.
McCullum.
How strange I seem to find you whenever I'm inquiring about that Skaal infestation.
I mean you no harm.
I'm not here for you. But once I put all the pieces of the puzzle together, I'm sure we'll have a little chat, you and me.
Stay away from me, McCullum. You and all your war dogs.
That I can't guarantee, Dr. Reed. But I'll let you go. For now.
I should probably leave the theater right now.
Be strong, brothers!
The West End should be safe now. But London is not. It would be wise to benefit from the Ascalon's protection while I continue my research during the Great Hunt. These people want me dead. I need to leave now. Just needs to be close to her audience to infect. Contagion through skin.
Ah!
Elizabeth, what are you doing here?
I've been formally asked to witness your triumph, my dear. After all, isn't it the natural role of a woman to support her man in victory?
But it's you who insisted I join the Ascalon.
Please forgive my giddiness. I'm just overcome by the thrill of finally being allowed within these hallowed halls.
You certainly have an inquisitive mind. It's quite something. Elizabeth Ashbury, only you can make me smile in these difficult times.
And the same to you, Jonathan Reed. Now go have your little chat with the chairman. I can see he's practically bursting to hear your report.
I personally went patrolling last night in the West End, and I spotted at least two foreign Echons. This is an outrage. We shall chase these intruders down.
Welcome back to the Ascalon Club, Lancebearer. Please, tell us the good news. Have you put an end to the epidemic?
My hypothesis was correct. Doris Fletcher was the source of the contagion in this part of town. She was probably the first to be infected.
And you cleansed her before the hunters, I've been told. Well done, Dr. Reed. You thrust your lance and pierced the very heart of the corruption.
I did my best.
The important thing is, we won a major battle for the survival of London. For that, we salute you.
Thank you, my lord.
Now, I have another task for you. One of the utmost importance. Perhaps even more so than the previous.
I'm listening.
It's time for you to perform a most sacred duty for the club. I want you to recruit a new vampire.
Recruit a new vampire? Are you sending me on some sort of diplomatic mission?
Not exactly. I want you to make Aloysius Dawson the Echon he deserves to be.
As you wish, my lord.
Good. Now go.
How would you like me to proceed?
Aloysius is waiting for you at the Dawson estate. Once the deed is done, I'll join you there to celebrate this momentous occasion.
Your word is my command.
Are you all right, Jonathan?
Lord Redgrave has just ordered me to turn Aloysius Dawson, to make him my progeny.
I see. And how do you feel about this?
Aloysius Dawson is the richest man in England. He'll be a very useful resource for the club.
The real question here is, why has his lordship given you this task?
Do you think it's some sort of trap?
Do you really want to know what I think about this?
I do, yes.
To make an immortal of a soulless blackguard like Aloysius Dawson will only lead to a disaster for London. The man is already dead inside.
Should I refuse? Perhaps politely suggest that Lord Redgrave turn the man into a vampire himself.
Don't you dare, my dear. According to what I've recently discovered, his lordship could kill you for even broaching the subject.
Really? Why?
I've recently found proof that the Earl of Bristol is of lesser lineage and only capable of creating skulls.
I'll be sure to keep that in mind. Thank you, Elizabeth. It looks like vampires have to obey Mendel's laws when producing progeny. Powers pass from one generation to another. That's why Dawson wants me to sire him. I cannot enter. I should find another way to get into the neighborhood. I think this passage could lead me close to Aloysius Dawson's mansion.
Your prey is mine!
It's locked.
Your blood is now mine.
I cannot enter. It's locked. It's locked, all right. It's locked. I cannot enter.
Thank you.
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Reed. Can I be of assistance?
Dr. Reed? Dr. Reed?
Is there anything wrong?
No, it's just... your name sounds familiar. And your face. Have we met before?
I think I would remember. So I suppose the answer is no.
That's odd. I'm certain I've already heard of you. My name is Pericles Baker. Does that mean anything to you?
I'm afraid not, sir. But it's a pleasure to meet you anyway.
The pleasure is mine, I guess. I only wish I could remember when it was that we met.
What can you tell me about Aloysius Dawson?
I've heard this is a man who has searched for his place in the world for a long time. I hope he found it.
Goodbye, Mr. Baker.
Seems fine. And some madness are now contagious.
It's locked, all right.
Good evening, sir. May I ask you what you're doing here at this late hour?
I'm conducting an investigation about the epidemic in this part of town.
And who are you, sir?
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed from the Pembroke Hospital. May I ask who you are? And why all the questions?
I'm Detective Inspector Charles Albright from Scotland Yard. And I don't find your answers convincing. What is a Pembroke doctor doing in the West End at this time of night?
I work for the Ascalon Club. Here is my permit to go freely about the city.
The Ascalon Club? You should have said so, sir. I must warn you, these streets are dangerous, and you'd better be careful.
Do you know anything in particular about a man called Aloysius Dawson?
Who doesn't know the man? I think he intervened personally to put an end to the police strike of last August.
What else can you tell me about him?
Aloysius Dawson is exactly the kind of powerful and influential man who could commit murder and get away with it, with just one phone call.
Goodbye, Detective Inspector Albright.
Goodbye, Dr. Jonathan Reed. I'm sure we'll talk again soon.
I cannot enter.
Too many murders to investigate them all. But they will not be forgotten
around us, but still, I don't feel afraid.
Jonathan Reed, at last we meet. The cards warned me you would visit tonight.
I beg your pardon, sir. Do I know you?
Of course you do. Our mutual friend, Dr. Swansea, can't speak highly enough of you. My name is Usher. Usher Talltree.
You are the leader of the Brotherhood, are you not?
Primate of the Brotherhood of St. Paul's Stole, to be precise. I'm really glad we met tonight. I love it when the cards tell me a truth.
The cards told you to expect me.
Yes, they can tell me everything. They told me that you are a new Ekon who relishes his blood diet.
Is there anything you could tell me about Aloysius Dawson?
Aloysius Dawson? Yes, of course. We met on several occasions. With time, he got deeper and deeper into the occult.
He's not the only one. It's been quite the fashion for several decades. The Golden Dawn, for instance, is just one example.
True. Aloysius was a member of the Golden Dawn until 1900. Then his thirst for dark knowledge grew. I'm talking forbidden texts, readings which blackened his heart.
Goodbye, sir. Until we meet again.
I rarely wander, yet it amuses me to converse with your kind. A red river, a song in the dark, the whispers of a sun. So many signs to...
It's locked. It's locked, all right. Dawson's mansion. Here I am at last. But the question remains, am I ready to make a dying man my progeny?
Finally, you're here, Dr. Reed. What took you so long?
I had to pass several of your barricades and outposts to access your mansion, sir.
Death, pestilence around us, and time is against me.
I see you've gathered some of the most expensive, albeit experimental, blood transfusion equipment available. All this could be so useful in a hospital.
Yes, yes. Since Lord Redgrave sent me a doctor to perform my conversion, I thought you might find some of these devices useful.
Most thoughtful. But tonight, I'm not here as a physician.
But I feel reassured that a specialist such as yourself would help me to escape the Reaper.
Very well. But before I proceed, I have a few questions for you.
If you must, but be quick, for I don't have much time left in this life.
First of all, I need to be sure that you know exactly what is going to happen to you, sir.
I can assure you I'm as informed as any man can be. I have planned for this moment, Dr. Reed. Planned very carefully.
I'm the only vampire in the room for now, so please indulge me.
All right, all right. What is it you wish to ask?
I will become your maker. Do you understand what that means?
Well, I certainly won't consider you my liege or some such drivel. You can be assured of that.
Let's move on, then.
Please, I'm cold and tired. I feel my life waning with every moment.
But first, before you embrace immortality, what would you do with such a gift?
That's a rather impertinent question, Dr. Reed. And I will do as I please.
Answer me all the same. What will your first action be as an immortal?
To save London. I will finance the most efficient quarantine ever seen. I will build a wall that will separate the sick boroughs from the healthy ones.
I've heard enough. It's time to proceed.
At last. All right, do what you have to do. If it hurts, so be it. I've been preparing such a long time for this.
Are you ready for immortality, Mr. Dawson? Drink now, and say farewell to life as you prepare to be reborn.
What do you mean, drink? What about the blood transfusion?
I'm the doctor and the vampire here, so I'll give the orders. Drink, sir. Now.
All right.
Good. That's enough. That's enough, I said.
I will not die. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Oh, no. You will die, sir. Steel yourself. You're already in death's grip.
Is it done, Dr. Reed? Is Aloysius Dawson reborn as expected?
Yes, my lord. Ascalon has a new recruit, as you ordered.
Wonderful news. I've waited for this outcome for so long. Tonight you served your country, the king himself, beyond all expectation.
Thank you, my lord.
No, thank you, Dr. Reed. Now, could you do me one last favor?
Of course. What is it?
Go outside and talk with that disgusting creature I saw waiting for you in front of his mansion.
I have no idea what you're talking about, but I'll have a look.
Good. I didn't kill her on the spot, for she claims to be a friend of yours. But don't you dare bring such a creature near me again.
We meet again at the strangest of times, young Ekon. So do you serve the Earl of Bristol now?
Old Bridget? What are you doing here?
Your friend, the wise Ekon. She sent me to warn you.
Lady Ashbury? You know her? Tell me what's going on.
The lady approached me but a few nights ago, wanting to meet the Sewer Skulls. Once she questioned Harriet Jones, she agreed to help us.
Harriet Jones is still with you then? How is she doing?
Harriet remains angry, but is recovering slowly. Her mind is twisted, but at least her body is healing.
Tell me what is going on.
The lady asked us to keep an eye on your mortal doctor friend while you were away. We spotted the hunters. They were discussing plans to attack tonight.
No time to lose, then. I must go there right away.
I shall return to my den. Have you a message for the lady? Should I see her before you?
Tell her I worry about her.
Do not, for she has had strength and wisdom for so much longer than you. Go now and take care, young Ekon, for the flames are rising.
cannot enter. What is this truck? Are the vampire hunters here already? Those bastards! What have they done to Edgar? McCullum and his thugs are taking the credit for Edgar's abduction. They really mean business. Looks like he's wounded. I better follow the blood.
Ultraviolet curtains and orichalcum powder. Dr. Swansea's always been a resourceful bastard. I bet he never told you he had this installed in case of a vampire attack. Says a lot about how much he trusts you.
What have you done with Edgar?
Don't worry. We don't kill humans. Even if your friend is deserving of a little punishment for one.
What are you talking about?
We know everything. Swansea and you created this bloody epidemic. You aim to unleash another disaster, just like William Marshall did.
No, I'm trying to put an end to it, just like you are.
You're his progeny, aren't you? Where is the monster hiding? It's still in England, isn't it?
I have no idea what you're talking about. Jeffrey, please listen to me.
No tricks. That shit won't work on me. We've found proof in the theater. Doris Fletcher was your first experiment. Now where is Marshall? Speak! So much for modern technology. Time for the tried and true. Do you know what this is, Beast? This is a drop of King Arthur's blood. The blood of a true defender of Britain. Stronger than your evil powers.
This is ridiculous. We're losing precious time.
True enough. Soon I'll bring your head before your coward of a father. Close your eyes! This is gonna hurt.
Next video, I'll be fighting him again, but for this one, I'll be leveling up. Sorry. Now, let's try this again.
If you're so innocent, why does simple life burn you so much?
Your poisonous bite is useless on me. Show some style. Fight like a man.
True light will cleanse you.
Thank you.
I'll pin you down! Poisonous bite is useless on me. Come on, Reed. Try something else. You're so innocent! Why does simple life burn you so much? Free wind prevails!
show some...
I know! It hurts, doesn't it?
I'm getting too aggravated, so I'm gonna call it done for today.